Hi, I'm Nicky Clayton. I'm Professor of Comparative Cognition in the Department of Psychology at Cambridge University. And I study how crows and children think. I suspect not. I have a feeling that humans probably don't taste very nice. Not that I've ever tried. Well, as in human societies, there's a lot of variation between animals within a species. And so, yes, there are a number of species of animals. Lots of birds come to mind that mate for life. The albatross is probably one of my favourite examples. It's also true of most members of the crow family. And when their mate goes, they very often mourn them. Now, some of them then would remain single for a long time, and others would repair more quickly, just as you see in humans, I guess. Well, we don't know that other animals don't have self-consciousness. I think that's the first point I would make. And I suppose some philosophers would take the strong stance that the only person who is certain of their own self-consciousness is that very person. We judge self-consciousness in others by sharing our feelings and our emotions, by talking, by reading and writing. The problem is there are no good agreed behavioural markers of consciousness, including self-consciousness, in animals because they're non-linguistic. There have been some tests done. The mark test is the classic one where you stick a little red dot on an area of the body, typically the head or ear or something like that, where the animal couldn't normally see, and look at how they respond to the image of themselves with a mark on in the mirror. But it's not really clear whether that is a good test of self-consciousness. I think most people in animal cognition would say that only a few animals pass the task, and they're all the big-brained social creatures that you would imagine to be highly intelligent and therefore most likely to have self-consciousness, if you think self-consciousness is something that is associated with being highly intelligent or being kind of similar to humans in some regards. And in that case, you find that only chimpanzees, dolphins, elephants and members of the crow family so far have passed the test. But whether that's just your free entry into Welcome to the Clever Club or whether it's really self-consciousness is another question.
All of a sudden, a lump of coal or a diamond would be worth the same thing.